Hey guys, what's up? So this video has been requested a lot since I first started doing videos. It's how to contour your face and how to highlight. So I'm in the middle of getting ready for my gig, so I decided just to record it really quickly. When you contour, you want to go ahead and use like a bronzer of some sort, something a couple of shades darker than your skin. I'm just using like a cheapy bronzer that I'm trying to get through for my Project 10 pan. So you want to take an angled brush. This one is the MAC 168. Yeah, 168. But any angled brush will work fine. So you're going to take your bronzer and we're going to start on the cheekbones. So you want to go like right where your cheeks are hollow, where you suck it in and it's hollow. And you want to bring it all the way up. And it's going to go basically from the top of your ear to your lip. So you just want to do this right here. Make like a line. And this is going to make your face look a little smoother and more chiseled. So you want to go ahead and blend it in. And then you want to blend it up as well into your temples. And this is, you'll see Kim Kardashian does this a lot. When you do this, you'll start seeing it in photos of celebrities. You'll see like, oh, they're contoured like right here. This is so they'll look a lot slimmer when the flash hits your face or when you're out, you know, at night. You can do this lightly for during the day, but I wouldn't suggest it for every day, like if you're in, you know, fluorescent lighting at the office or something, but you can do it super lightly for day wear. So you just keep taking that and blending it up a bit until it's really blended and there's no hard edges. I'm going to find like a powder brush. Here we go. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and do the other cheek. You can already see how the light's kind of bringing that in because it creates a shadow. So you do that. Make a line. And you need the angled brush so you can really get into the hollows right there. And then just kind of bring it back up again. And this, a lot of people can do this, you know, before you're powdering. I like to do it after because I like it a little darker, a little more dramatic. But if you don't want it as dark, you can put your powder over it, like a loose setting powder. You can also do this using like a darker concealer. I have my hard candy set that I got like in medium, so these are darker colors. So I could also do that like after I put my foundation on, I could use like the cream colors and then just powder over it. So that might be something you can do for the daytime. But just make sure that it's all blended really, really well. Because you don't want to look contoured. I mean, you want it to look natural. So that's all blended nicely right there. Also, we're going to do this area right here, your jawline, and this creates a shadow, but make sure you blend it down because you don't want to look like you have like a funky, like a foundation line, like all 80s style. So you just want to go ahead and go up a bit and right through here. And this is going to make you look a lot slimmer in the face as well. You know, take away any little chin fat or whatever we got going on down there. So I got that done. Now you just want to kind of blend it inwards like that in short strokes. And don't put too much right here because it'll look kind of weird. This just creates like a shadow, especially in pictures if you're going out. So let me see. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is my nose area. And I know a lot of people have been asking about this. With your nose area, you want to start from up on the eyebrow all the way down your nose, all the way around the tip, and all the way back up to the eyebrow. So you need to make sure it's pretty straight because you can make your nose look crooked like this. So you want to start right here and just kind of sweep down. And I'm using a MAC 252 brush. Sorry, it's like this. But any big shading brush will work fine as long as it has like a dense tip. Just like this. And sorry if I'm looking to the side. That's where my mirror's at. Just kind of dust it right there on the tip. See? And then you want to go back to the other side and bring it back down and blend it in with the tip as well. Now what I do is I usually just kind of clean the brush off on tissue and then I just blend it down. So it just creates a shadow. So you see from the side there's not a line, but from the front my nose already looks slimmer. So you just want to blend it in really well. And I'm going to show you guys the whole thing. I'm going to put my blush on and everything and the highlighting. So your face is now contoured. You can already see how it looks slimmer right there. I'm going to put my blush on real quick. And I'm using a liquid one from the Dream Mousse collection from Maybelline. Just going to smudge a little bit on here with my finger. So whenever you put your blush on, just put your blush like right over the contouring. Oh, this blush is kind of dried out. Okay, so mine's a little bit shimmery, but I'm going to put a powder over it. This is also kind of like a Kim Kardashian cheek. I mean, she has kind of like pinky or peachy cheeks, and then she kind of has like the contouring and the highlighting going on. I got that on. And now I'm going to go ahead and use Mary Kay Apricot Breeze. And I'm going to use the same angled brush. And just going to sweep that over. Just like that. Make sure it's all blended in. You see, it's kind of blending in with the contouring. And that's what you want to do. You want to blend that right in with the contouring. Because you don't want to have like a big brown line or big bronzy line like right in the center of your cheek. That'll just look weird. I'm going to do the other cheek. That. Make sure you blend it in real well. You can even bring it up just a little bit right here, not too much. Okay, and now for the highlighting. A highlighter comes in powder form or cream form, or it even comes like in little like a liquid form. I like to use powders. Sometimes I'll use like a cream form if it's more of a like in winter when it's dry, you know, when your face isn't gonna get all oily. I have one right here, and this is from Estee Lauder, and this is Shimmering Jewel Powder. So it's just like a white, like, shimmery powder. See right there. And also I have from Hard Candy, this is Tiki, and you can get this one at Walmart for about, I think it was like $6. And this is also more of a glowy effect right there. So this is the one I'm going to use today. So you can take the same angled brush, and you just want to go right over your cheeks right here into like a C form, like right under where your eye ends and go into a C. So we're gonna do that, and you just want to kind of dust it just into a C. See how it's giving me like a shine? So you have to remember, you want to contour all the places that are like deep into your face, and that, I mean, also, you know, your eyes, when you do a crease, that's a contour. So when you use darker stuff. And see, like that. And now we're going to see the nose come together in just a few seconds. See, the cheeks already look nice and glowy. Now you can just take your finger into this and just rub it in to whatever you have, even if it's a liquid, and then just come right down the center of your nose. And sometimes they can make you look too shiny. So find a product that works best for you that doesn't make you look like a greasy... faced person. See, there you go. So that's how you contour your face, and then you carry on with the rest of your makeup, and then the whole look comes together. Just make sure that your cheeks are really, really blended. Just, you can take a kabuki or a powder brush and just blend all three of the colors together, the bronzer, the blush, the highlighter, and that gives you like a whole complete look, just like that. And you can even do it on your nose area as well. And there you go. That's how to contour and highlight your face. And I hope your face turns out awesome and looks slimmer than ever. See you guys later. Bye.